Welcome to science class. So we were discussing about the separation of substances from a mixture and also studied why we have to separate the substances. Children, we have to separate the substances, then we can use them. Some substances we have to clean. So these are the processes before using any material, before using any things. So some methods we studied in this lesson are hand picking method to separate stones or sawdust from any unwanted impurities from rice or other grains, threshing to separate lighter substances from heavier substances, and winnowing also done in a big quantity used to separate heavier and lighter components of a mixture by wind or by blowing air. And sieving is also the method to separate the flours or small, to separate the grains or flour. The sieving removes pieces of stones, stalk and husk that may still remain with wheat after threshing and winnowing. So you can see, this is a sieve. We say sanigi in Kannada. While cooking, your mother uses this sieve to sieve the wheat flour or jowar and rice, etc. So similar thing we have noticed in the construction of buildings, to separate pebbles and stones from the sand. Okay. Then I told you to do such activity, you also at home, you can do, but nobody shown. Now do and show, children. There are some methods to separate the materials which are dissolved. Children, we can separate if they are mixed, we can see through our eyes. Physically we can separate them. But whereas the some substances, we cannot, not possible to separate components of a mixture by these methods of winnowing, hand picking or threshing. So what is that? Suppose salt or sugar is mixed with water. Then how can you mix, how can you separate these components of this mixture of salt and any other things, salt like sugar or, okay, it is by only possible through sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Let us see what are these sedimentation. When the heavier component in a mixture settles after some time, after water is added to the mixture, the process is called sedimentation. And when the water along with dust is removed, the process is called decantation. What is that decantation? When the water along with sawdust is removed, this process is called decantation. So let us find a few other mixture that can be separated through sedimentation and decantation. The principle is used for separating a mixture of two liquids that do not mix each other. For example, oil and water. Do the oil and water mix each other? No. If a mixture of such liquid is allowed to stand for some time, they form two separate layers. Then the component that forms the top layer can be separated by decantation. We can separate by separating to another content or glass. And let us again consider a mixture of solid and liquid. After preparing tea, what do to remove the tea leaves? Usually we use strainer to remove tea leaves. I shown you, children, how to separate the prepared tea to get tea from tea powder. Now try decantation also. It helps a little, but do you still get a few layer in your tea? Now pour the tea through a strainer. Did all the tea leaves remain in the strainer? This process is called filtration. So these are also methods of separation when the substances are not possible to separate by hand picking, winnowing and threshing. So this method of separation is called filtration. There are some methods, examples to separate water that we use. Do all of us at all times get safe water to drink? No. Our drinking water is not safe to drink. We cannot drink the water directly from the tap. Sometimes water supplied through the tap may be muddy. Usually in a rainy season, you might have seen children, it is mixed with so many impurities. Not only muddy, it is also mixed with harmful microorganisms. The water collected from the ponds, river may also be muddy, especially after rains. Okay, so such water is also should be purified before using for any purpose. So separation to remove insoluble impurities like soil from the water is another method. How to do it? It's also through the process called filtration. For that we need filter paper. In the fifth class we studied children using filter paper. See, like this we have to fold the paper like a cone, then keeping in a filter panel, and below it we have to keep a container to collect the purified water. Okay, the mixture is then poured on the filter paper. The salt particles in the mixture do not pass through the filter paper. Then it remains on the filter. The purified water, filtered water is collected in the glass here. Okay. Also, where it is used, children? Have you observed in your daily events? There are some instances. Think about it, children. In juice shops, or your mother also prepares juices out of vegetables or fruits. So how the juice is prepared? We cannot drink the juice or vegetable juice directly. Usually it is filtered before drinking to separate the seeds and solid particles of the pulp. So this method is known as filtration. It is also used in the process of preparing cottage cheese in our home. So all that you have to observe, children, then you will get the knowledge of separation of substances. Suppose sugar or salts are mixed in water. How will you separate? So we have a glass of water here. When we put the sugar into glass of water, the salt is mixed. You can take sugar or salt. How you can separate it? Yes, it is possible. We can also separate the salt from the sugar by evaporation method. Heating the beaker of containing salt water. After heating some time, the process of conservation of water into the water vapor is called evaporation. The water evaporates after heating, then the salt content will remain in the container. So let me repeat once again how it is separated by means of evaporation. Salt or sugar is separated by process called evaporation. Evaporation is also a natural process where you might have observed during summer season the water evaporates from the water bodies such as lakes, ponds, rivers. Then the water remains there only which is containing most of the quantity of salt there. When the most of the quantity of water is evaporated, the remaining salt quantity remains in the water bodies only. Okay, this process is called evaporation. This is natural process. Why the seawater is salty? This is the reason, children. Seawater contains many salts mixed in it. One of these salt is common salt. The salt we are using for cooking is nothing but the common salt. It is prepared by process evaporation. I mean, it is not prepared in the factories. It is naturally prepared. Then it is carried to the factories to make fine powder or to mix the iodine content or further process. I hope you have come to know the evaporation process. Let me repeat once again. The process of conversion of water into its vapor is called evaporation. So the process of evaporation takes place continuously wherever water is present in the water bodies. Okay. So use of more than one method of separation we will study in next class. So read the lesson, children. And you also try these methods of separation of substances by filtration, by evaporation method.